Shalom everyone, this is Pastor Raphael. I greet you wherever you are. If today is your first time watching me, kindly subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that anytime I load video, you'll be the first person to be notified. Thank you for making time to watch me. I'm going to share something important with you. There has been so many questions that has been asked, especially many Christians have asked me so many questions. Why is it that they give their tithes, they give offering, they support church building, they support even the pastors, they do whatever in their capacity to make sure the kingdom of God is moving on. They do everything, they pledge, they pay their vows, but they don't see results. Many of them have come to me, they said, we have heard, we have sat under many anointed men of God who has preached, give and you shall receive, give and you shall receive. Pay your tithe and God will fight the devourer. Pay your tithe and God will open the windows of heaven. And their concern is, they have done all this, but they have never experienced that blessing they are looking for. Now, today, my only duty is to teach you or show you what to do. Don't just carry your tithe and take it to the church. Don't just carry your offering and take it to the church. Partly, the problem may be coming from you, the Christian, and partly from the pastors or the church, because if they teach you, you will do it. And partly, some Christians don't want to learn. They just follow the tradition. Take your offering and put it in the offering bowl. Now, today, I'm going to teach you how to present your tithe to touch God or to go before the presence of God, for God to smell your offering or your tithe. It's very, very important. This that I'm teaching you were done by our forefathers, the Israelites, Moses, Abraham, David. They did it and the result is amazing. As a matter of fact, I have taught so many Christians who came to me with the concern, and I taught them what to do, and they did it, and they have been sending message, calling, Pastor Raphael, the result is so amazing. Since I started doing it, paying my tithes, I'm seeing an amazing result. Things are working, God is protecting me. So just relax and watch. Now, in doing this, you need three things. Number one, you need salt. If you have not watched my previous video about salt baths, kindly go and type salt baths, the power of salt baths, and you will see it. I spoke extensively about it, the importance of salt baths, how it helps us in cleansing our spirit. And then you need a frankincense. Then you need your incense burner. You need salt, frankincense, and the incense burner. And then your tithe or your offering is very important. Now, what you need to do, don't rush when it comes to this. Don't rush at all. Take time. And mostly you can do it Friday or Saturday. Before Sunday, you go to church. Friday or Saturday, before Sunday, you go to church, because you need to make time with God. Don't just go and pray over the tithe or the offering and you pick and you send it to the church. Reason why people give their offering and they don't see the blessing is because they don't do it the right way. They don't do it the right way. Now, there is a biblical foundation on how to give the right seed or offering. When you look at Cain and Abel in the Bible, they are a typical example on how God accepted offering and rejected offering. One of them, I'm giving you an assignment, go and look for the scripture. I don't want to give it to you. I told you here is called Shalom Studies. We study the word of God. I know most of you know about the story, but just say, go and also dig deep into the Bible and learn something about it. It will help you. So Cain and Abel, one of them presented a rightful offering and one presented a wrongful offering. Now, God accepted, smelled the rightful one because the brother presented the good fat sheep to God, when the other brother presented the rotten fruit. Now, let me ask you a question. As a mere human being, can you eat rotten cabbage? Can you eat rotten cucumber? Can you eat rotten tomatoes? Can you eat rotten onions? No. So why then do you present God a rotten things? So these are all factors you need to look into when you are giving God. Some of you, our major problem is we see our tithe, our offering, that it is the pastor or the man of God or the church who is going to eat it. That is where we miss it. That is where we miss the blessing. Because the moment that comes into your mind, that comes into your head, you have lost the blessing attached to tithe. You have lost the blessing attached to offering. But if within you, you prepare yourself and know that you are going to give it to God, you will go into the act of worship and prepare yourself, prepare the offering before you take it to the church. Now, I have two notes here. Let me show you something. This is what some of us will do. This note on my left is clean money. This note on my right is dirty. Now, which of them will you choose? Your guess is right as mine. I'll choose the clean one, because I want clean money in my wallet, in my pocket. What am I going to do with this dirty money? But see, that is what we do. We use this one to buy tomatoes in the market, and then we use this one and give it to God. Because God deserves the dirty one. Because God is the pastor who is going to eat the money. So we pick the dirty one and we give it to God. Already, this is a rotten seed. This is a rotten fruit. You are giving a rotten one. So you take it to God, you give it to God, and you don't see any result. Nothing is happening. Because you rather respect the tomato seller, the butcher, the onion seller, the cucumber seller, and you give the clean money, and the God who gave you the money, you give him the dirty money. So that is one blockage that blocks our blessing. The seed we give matters. So this is what I do. Before I give tithe, I go to the bank. If all the money I have are dirty, I go to the bank and I change the money into clean money. I go and tell them I want all clean notes. Then I come, put it in envelope, worship God with it, do what I'm going to teach you. Then I present it to God. I am giving it to God, not the pastor. So now, if you read, I will not read the scripture. If you read Leviticus chapter 2, verse 13, God said to Moses and the children of Israel, said, season your offering with salt. Season your offering with salt. Now, it is called salt of the covenant or salt covenant. Now, in the Hebrew setting, when you come, you said salt mean, he said, Melech, Beth El Elohika. Malek bet Elohika, meaning Malek simply means salt, bet simply means covenant, Elohika mean God. So when you combine them together, Malek bet Elohika, Malek bet Elohika, meaning the salt of the covenant with God. The salt of the covenant with God. Now, when you read Leviticus chapter 2, verse 6, it also tells you, God also went ahead and told them, season your offering with also frankincense. Now, frankincense is one of the ingredients that every Christian need in his or her home. You need it in your home. is very important. It's just like a mere gun, but very powerful. God has put spiritual in it. God has blessed those trees that we see. They have spiritual attributes to our health, to our spirit. One of the functions of frankincense, it purifies us, it cleans us. So when you burn frankincense in your home, you are banishing away negative energies. You are banishing away, you are clearing your home from all the demonic spirit that has occupied the corners of your house. They cleanse. That is why God always will instruct the high priest to do what? To burn the frankincense on the altar. Why does the high priest do that? To purify the altar, to cleanse the room before the presence of God will come. So I'm going to show you the experiment, how to present your offering to God, how to present your tithe to God. So go with me, let me show you the experiment. God bless you. So these are my ingredients, the things I'm going to use to teach you how to present your offering, your tithe, your sacrifice, your pledge to God, for God to smell it. Now, if you look on my plate, you can see I have my frankincense. I'm going to pick one or two of them and put it in my incense burner. Now, if you look here also, I have my salt. My salt, which is very important. Now, look at this one. I love frankincense. They smell good, they smell nice, they are so sweet. And I love it because I understand what they do. I love it because they are so powerful. So please, if you're a Christian, make sure you get as much as you can. If every day you burn it in your house, you are doing yourself a very great service. You are saving yourself from so many, many, many pollution, so many, many attacks. So it's very important, get one. So now, I also have my seed. I'm using this one as a seed for today. I can't give God 1,000. That is not me. I can't give God 1,000. But see, I'm not going to use the dirty money. I'm going to use the clean money. Because I'm not just going to give it to any human being. I'm going to give it to God. So God must smell the aroma of a clean, fat animal. This one can go to the tomato seller. This one can go to the onion seller. But this one must go to God. So I'll put this one down. And now this is what I'm going to do. I told you earlier on, God said, season your offering with salt. So if you put your tithe, your money in the envelope, bring it out. Now you pick the salt. This is the salt. Pick some of it, pour it on it, and you pray, Lord, I season my offering. The reason why you are doing it is because you don't know where this money has passed. You don't know where the money has gone. Some of the money might be money from prostitutes, money from, it's a stolen money. Money where they have killed somebody, it's a murdering money. Money from lies, all sorts of money. Probably this money has passed through a witchcraft. They have done so many sacrifices on it. They have sacrificed animal blood. They have done so. It is polluted. It's polluted. God will not accept it. God will be smelling it. Even if you put the frankincense and the smoke goes up, God will be smelling it, but he will be smelling polluted money, polluted seed. So that is why God said to the children of Israel, season your offering with salt. Season it with salt. Please kindly read Leviticus chapter 2, verse 13. Is there how God ordered them to use salt to season their offering and also to make a covenant with them. So what you are doing, if you put the salt, you are purifying your money or your offering, and at the same you are entering into covenant. So this is how you pray. Lord, I season this my seed. I season my offering. I cleanse it and I purify it to be holy. Lord, as I give, I enter into covenant of sorts of perpetual blessing in the mighty name of Jesus. Then when you finish, When you finish, you pick the frankincense. You pick the frankincense. At least these two is okay. Please don't put the money in the fire. You pick two frankincense and you pray over it. The prayer is very, very important. If you don't pray, it will not work. You have to pray and activate the natural God-given power in the frankincense. So this is how you pray. Father, Lord, I speak life into this frankincense. I command its natural element of purification, of cleansing. Lord, as the smoke burns out, let it smell the aroma, smell my offering in the name of Jesus. Then when you finish, you put the frankincense in the fire. Now just look at how the smoke will come. Very beautiful. So it's coming. Now this is my seed. For now, I pass it through. Lord, I present my tithe. I present my offering. Smell the aroma of my seed. Smell the aroma of my tithe in the name of Jesus. As you do that, you are presenting. You are presenting your offering. You see, the smoke, the frankincense smoke is passing through. So as the smoke goes up, God will smell your offering. God will smell your offering, and then it will come down with answers. This is a practical proving experiment where you will receive. That is when you will see God protecting you, opening the windows of heaven to pour his blessing. God will devour the enemy fighting your blessing because he has smelled your sacrifice. He has smelled your blessing. So you pass it through like this. You pass it through. As you pass it through, you are waving it. God, I thank you. Accept my offering. Accept my tithe in the name of Jesus. God, as the smoke occupy this place, smell the aroma of my offering. Smell it now. Take time. Don't rush. Take time and do it. Don't be with your phone. Make sure you leave your phone out. Don't rush. If you are going to do this particular exercise, make sure you have enough time and you do it and you see the results. So you wave it. You wave it. As the frankincense burns, the smoke go out. God will smell it. God will smell it. God will smell it. God bless you so much. Kindly subscribe to the channel. Share this video with your friends who have been suffering from not seeing the blessings of God, but they have been given. And God will richly bless you. Until I see you once again, I say shalom alive to you. God bless you.